Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the 10th experiment on optical detectors. For an optical detector, like LED gives the optical output, which is directly proportional to the input forward current, optical detector converts an input optical power into an electrical current, and there is a direct relationship. Secondly, the optical detector will give us this response only when the energy of a photon is greater than the energy of the band gap. So taking these two as an input, we'll be designing this practical to see the electrical output current from a detector and also the responsivity of your or response of a detector with the changing wavelength. So the relations that we have to use is So the relations that we have to use or implement is IP, and IP is for the photocurrent, the current from a detector, and R is the responsivity. So if we see here, the inputs that we require is efficiency, the input optical power, and the wavelength of the incident photon. Now, once we have all our input terminals, now what we want to see is IP, the responsivity, and the energy of a photon. For that, we will add our gauges. Now we have all the three input gauges where we can measure our current, responsivity, and photon. We can add our digital displays and the RAM, color RAM. In addition to this, we want to see the plot. For that, we will be using an extended diagram for IP versus PO to see that the response is inverse of what LED is giving. So IP versus PO. And the second graph we need is, for responsivity versus the wavelength. Now we will set the axes and also set the line width and set the colors for better visibility of our results. Now we have added the digital displays to all and also set the range of incident optical power, the wavelength to 1.7 microns. So it is unit of the wavelength of a photon is in micrometer. So we have set it till 1.10, added the color ramps and digital displays, also named the axes for the plots. Now we will go to our block diagram windows and make the connections as per the equations. Now one thing we need to remember here is that what is HF by E? It is nothing but the energy of the photon, where energy of a photon is equivalent to hc by lambda e. It will give me the energy in electron volt. This constant hc and e are on the constant, and this equation is also equivalent to 1.24 by lambda, unit is electron volt. So we'll be using this relations for our calculations. So we'll go to the block diagram window. Now on our block diagram window, first we'll calculate the energy of a photon. So we know that it is 1.24 divided by the wavelength. So I'll simply use a divide. Wavelength is in the denominator, and I'll add a constant in the numerator, which is 1.24. So this is my energy of a photon in electron volts. Now, if we see the equation of IP, it is eta PO by the energy of the photon. It is HF by E, that is energy of a photon in electron volts. So what we will do is eta P naught divided by the energy of a photon that we have calculated. So again, we'll use our multiplier. So it is eta PO, and then we need one divided by the energy of photon in electron volt. This is our IP. Now, if we look at the expression of R, it is nothing but IP by P naught. So we can simply use a divide and do this. The numerator is IP and the denominator is P naught. So we get our responsivity. Now we want to check here IP. So I'll connect IP to the Y terminal and to the X terminal, I'll connect the PO. I'll set the reset button by create constant to false. Similarly, for this plot, I need responsivity, which I'll connect it to the Y terminal, and to the X, I need wavelength. Here again, I'll do the reset. Now, the problem with this block diagram, if we simply follow this equation, is it will give us a direct relationship or a straight line with the change in the wavelength. But we know that as the wavelength increases, the energy of the photon reduces. And we may come across a condition when the wavelength is increasing that the photon energy is less than the band gap energy. And hence, at that time, there will be no response for the incident photon. So that condition is not included. For including that condition, we'll be using a structure, that is a case structure. And to, the condition to it will be, we'll be using a comparison. The comparison is when the energy of a photon is greater than the energy of band gap of the material. So we need to have that as an input first. So we will just first include the material. So it will be a band gap energy of the material in electron volts. We'll just set it to say 3. So the comparison is the material we are given. So till this condition, right? So this is our condition, which will have two values, true or false. If this condition is true, that means my responsivity will be as we have calculated. So I'll just remove this connection and here simply add a multiplier where to one arm, I'll just add a constant, which is 1, and to the other arm, I'll just add the value of responsivity calculate. And this, I'll feed it to my XY. Now, under the false condition, we know that false condition is the energy of a photon is, false condition is energy of a photon is less than the band gap. So there will be no response. Our responsivity is 0. So what we will do is simply add a multiplier and the constant to one arm, we will keep it as 0. And the other arm, it will be, we'll just connect the responsivity. So there is no response and we'll connect it. So this gives us our full block diagram. Now we want the response to be continuous. Therefore, we will be adding a while loop. Now let's see the response of this. So once I have set it, I have just run it. You can see there's some responses. Now if I continuously run it and if I change the incident optical power, you can see that IP is changing, but I'm not able to see the response. You know how to overcome this is just by adding the whole block diagram into the inside a while loop. So this will help us to get our continuous curve. So I just put whole block diagram inside the while loop and add, create a control. Now I'll just again rerun it. So if I change my incident optical power, you can see a continuous line. Now I'll keep it at constant and vary the wavelength. So you can clearly see as my wavelength has changed, with the lower values, the response is linear. So you can see that I'll just set my wavelength to say 1.5. And if I vary my incident power, you can clearly see there is a linear relationship between the incident power and the photo incident power and the photo current of the device, and also the responsivity curves gives us a linear relationship for the lower wavelength. As the wavelength increases, the energy of a photon reduces, and as it goes beyond a certain value where the energy of a photon is less than the band gap energy of a photon, there is a drop in the response to zero. This is what you have to do and plot it on a graph paper. For that, as I explained you for an LED, here also you can do it. As I explained you for an LED, here also you can go to the visible items, cursor legend. You can just say create a cursor, single point. Now you can just vary this cursor. You will keep on getting the values. You can just note down these values and make your plot. Similarly, here also I'll just add a cursor, go to visible items, cursor legend, right click on the cursor, create a single point. I'll just again move it and show, so we can just get our readings and plot it. The other way is just right click on it, go to export, export data to Excel. So what you will see is data to Excel, that will give you an Excel sheet with all the data. You can see whatever is the redundant data that can be removed and used. Thank you.